Thousands of earthquakes have struck this week, including more than 500 today underneath the Chilean volcano, and as a result, its alert level was raised. This all occurred at the Planchon-Peteroa volcano, located 40 miles or 64 kilometers east-southeast of a major agricultural city of Curico. This descent of volcanic unrest seemingly began on July 9th, further escalating on July 13th, and remaining constantly high ever since. To prevent confusion, I want to clarify that this seismic activity primarily consists of two types of earthquakes: volcano tectonic quakes and long period quakes. Volcano tectonic earthquakes are frequently seen at many volcanoes, even ones that are not erupting and have not erupted in a long time, which can occur due to a number of processes such as magma movement or just regional tectonic forces. In the case of the Planchon-Peteroa volcano, these types of events have week over week stayed the same at a rate of about 20 to 50 a week. What hasn't stayed the same and is the main driver of this swarm are the long period earthquakes, which previously occurred at a rate of 0 to 10 a week, but are now occurring at a rate of more than 3,000 a week. Long period earthquakes occur at frequencies below 5 Hz and produce weaker but longer duration shaking than a volcano tectonic earthquake. These long period earthquakes, per a direct quote from the US Geological Survey, are not caused by brittle failure, but rather are thought to be caused by fluids moving through cracks beneath the ground. These fluids can be hydrothermal, water, or magma. So, with so many long-period earthquakes striking beneath a large stretch of Planchon-Peteroa, which liquid is the culprit? Most likely hydrothermal fluids, aka water. But why would you raise a volcano's alert level for simple water movement? Wouldn't that seem misplaced? Surprisingly, no. Normally, magmatic fluids at this volcano are trapped beneath a caprock barrier of sorts deep beneath the surface. Yet, if something such as an increased magma volume, especially at shallower depths, occurs, it can break portions of this caprock. This allows fluids to migrate upwards, generating all of the earthquakes we are observing. While no measurable uplift has been observed, the center of the volcano where its recent eruptions have all occurred has expanded slightly outwards horizontally, and this to me suggests a recent arrival of a batch of magma below ground. While no signs yet exist that magma is actively rising to the surface, an implied increased heat flow creates a potential more immediate hazard: phreatic eruptions. Phreatic eruptions are essentially large volcanic steam explosions that specifically occur due to direct interaction with heat transfer from a body of magma. They are the toughest type of eruption to predict in advance, often seemingly occurring at random, making them essentially impossible to predict. However, these types of phreatic eruptions are exponentially more likely to occur when some form of volcanic unrest is ongoing, such as right now. Of course, the vast majority of volcanic unrest episodes worldwide don't result in one or more phreatic eruptions, meaning no eruption is still the most likely eventual outcome here. However, to prevent a potential for casualties, a 2-kilometer exclusion zone was declared in all directions around its recently active craters to avoid this area. But let's hypothetically jump ahead 6 months and suppose the unlikely event has happened that Planchon-Peteroa not only produced a series of phreatic eruptions, but also a magmatic eruption. What hazards might this pose? All eruptions at Planchon-Peteroa have been a level of explosive, so minor to moderate ash emissions could disrupt regional air traffic, and any ash that gets into regional drinking water and streams could pollute them temporarily. Closer to the volcano, some pyroclastic flows could occur, volcanic bombs could be ejected, gas emissions could be problematic downslope, and even a lava flow could form in advance. However, the main hazard Planchon-Peteroa poses is Lahars. These have occurred during some of its historical eruptions, impacting segments of both the Tino and Claro rivers. This can sometimes pose a flooding hazard to even some faraway communities and settlements. However, such lahars are largely dependent on eruption directly melting large volumes of glacial ice, which doesn't always happen during Planchon-Peteroa's eruptions. Stay tuned for more updates. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.